हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे माय टॉपिक फॉर डिस्कशन इज ओओजेनेसिस और ओजेनेसिस। सो आई ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू इन माय लास्ट लेक्चर व्हाट इज गैमेटोजेनेसिस। सो द गैमेटोजेनेसिस इज द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ गैमेट। मींस व्हाट इज गैमेट? गैमेट मींस स्पर्म और ओवा। सो गैमेटोजेनेसिस इज ब्रॉडली divided into two processes. One is oogenesis, another one is spermatogenesis. So today I am talking about oogenesis. Oogenesis means the formation of mature ovum from the oogonia. So oogenesis is a process by the formation of mature ovum from the oogonia. So now what will happen that the most primitive primordial germ cells, they will appear in the wall of yolk sac here around 4th or 5th week, and then they will proliferate by the process of mitosis, and then they will migrate towards the gonads of developing female, means towards the ovary. Now they are here in the ovary. So after birth there will be no oogonia in the ovary. Before birth all the oogonia are converted into primary oocytes. And after birth there are no oogonia in the ovary, and at birth about 2 million primary oocytes are formed. So around 5th month of intrauterine life, the 7 million primary oocytes, and which remain only 2 million at the birth. So now the primordial germ cell which proliferate by the process of mitosis, they will migrate to the gonads of female, means in the ovary. So what they will do in the ovary? This is primordial germ. So now I will talk about the prenatal development. There are two stages, the postnatal development and the prenatal development. Now I will tell about the prenatal development. So this primordial germ cell which proliferate by mitosis and then migrate to gonads of the developing female, means the ovary. Now it is here in the ovary. Now so the genetic makeup of primordial germ cell, it is 23 maternal chromosome, 23 paternal chromosome, means diploid. So this primordial germ cell, it has 46 diploid number of chromosome and 2n amount of DNA, 1n from mother and 1n from father. So it has totally. Now this oogonia by mitosis will form primary oocyte, and this primary oocyte with flat epithelial cells called follicular cells. These cells are follicular cells. Now this primary oocyte will start meiosis 1, and before meiosis 1 they will replicate their DNA, and after this now this primary oocyte around with epithelial cells will arrested at the very first stage, which is prophase of meiosis 1, will arrest it. It will arrest it here in the prophase of meiosis 1. So what I told you, that gametogenesis is the process by which gamete formation occur. So there are two broad processes. Today I am only talking about oogenesis. This is the formation of mature ovum from oogonia. So first of all, the primitive primordial germ cell around 5th or 4th week will appear in the yolk sac, wall of yolk sac. Then they will migrate to the ovary. So in the ovary, the primordial germ cell undergo mitosis. So in the mitosis, they will replicate their DNA and they form the oogonia. Oogonia again undergo mitosis and they will form primary oocyte. This primary oocyte will start meiosis 1, and in meiosis 1, the stage 1, which is prophase, they get arrested here. Now this primary oocyte, it is arrested at prophase. Prophase has many stages. One of stages is diplotene stage. So primary oocyte, it is arrested at diplotene stage. Now this primary oocyte, which have around the follicular cells, most of them will degenerate. At the birth, around 2 million, around the menstruation, only 40,000 cells will remain. And now the FSH will release and start stimulating these follicular cells. Now this primary oocyte or primordial follicle, which it is also called primordial follicle, it is converted into growing follicle. What is difference in growing follicle is that this epithelial cell which was surrounding it, now it become cuboidal cell. Now out of this 40,000 primordial follicle, only 5 to 15 cells will called growing follicle, means they start growing and they are surrounded by cuboidal cells. Now this growing follicle, it is converted into, this is ovum, and it is surrounded by, now the cuboidal cells are become many. So now this is called stratified cuboidal. So now this ovum or primordial follicle, it is surrounded by many cuboidal cells. So layer. So now it is called stratified cuboidal epithelium, and this is ovum, and outside it there is a connective tissue layer which is also derived from ovarian stroma. Now the stratified cuboidal epithelium will start a new layer, which is glycoprotein layer, which is around the ovum outside and follicular cells inside this layer here, this layer which is outside the ovum but inside the follicular cells. So this is called zona pellucida. This layer is called zona pellucida. So now what is secondary follicle? So first here there is ovum, and surrounding the ovum, outside the ovum, there is zona pellucida, a glycoprotein layer. So now some follicular cells which are only surrounding around this zona pellucida, this layer, some cells only remain surrounding it. So these cells are called cumulus oophorus. So these cells are called cumulus oophorus, which only surround this glycoprotein layer, means zona pellucida. Now some follicular cell will proliferate and they enlarge and form a fluid filled space which appear between the cells and fuse with each other. This is called antrum. Where it form? Here. This is layer of follicular cells, and they fuse and they form here a space which is called antrum. This is called antrum, and surround this there was a connective tissue layer. Here I show you, this connective tissue layer is now become thickened, which was derived from ovarian stroma. This connective tissue layer, which is thickened, this is called theca folliculi. This is called theca folliculi. Now, follicles will grow, make secondary follicle, but primary oocyte still arrested here at the diploid stage, and now there this thicker cell they start producing estrogen. So now this secondary follicle, it is converted into mature follicle or graafian follicle. This is only one. Graafian follicle is only one. So what it form is that mature follicle or secondary follicle. Now primary oocyte completes its first meiotic division and it will form secondary oocyte along with first Wallace body. This secondary oocyte with all the cytoplasm, this is secondary oocyte, and this is with a little cytoplasm, this is the first polar body. And now this secondary oocyte immediately start in its meiosis 2, and it is surrounded by this zona pellucida, cumulus oophorus cell, and here the antrum. These follicles which were originally fused and they formed the hair's antrum, and there is, and this thickened layer of theca cells which were producing estrogen. Now this mature follicle will be the only one, and around 14 day now graafian follicle is fully ready for ovulation. Now just 3 hours before the ovulation, secondary oocyte arrange material on the spindle, and then it is again arrested at meiosis 2, stage 2 means metaphase. Now this remaining cells, this remaining follicular cells and theca cells, these remaining granulosa or theca cells will convert into a yellowish mass which is called corpus luteum, and this corpus luteum will produce progesterone. This will produce progesterone. Now here is the fallopian tube. Now this ovum with cumulus oophorus cells, this cumulus oophorus cells, it is taken up by fallopian tube, and it has secondary oocyte with one polar body which is arrested at meiosis 2, stage 2 means metaphase. So I tell you, I already told you everything about postnatal development. So first there were primordial follicle or primary oocyte around 40,000 cell which was arrested at diploid stage. Then only around 40, from 40 around only 5 or 15 cells will convert into growing follicle which are surrounded by cuboidal cells, and then this cuboidal will convert it into multilayer stratified cuboidal layer. So these cells will surround the ovum, and then outside the ovum there is one layer which is called glycoprotein layer, zona pellucida, and their connective tissue layer, and which will convert it into theca cell in the secondary follicle. And in the secondary follicle, these follicle which are around the zona pellucida, they will they called cumulus oophorus. And the follicle which are fused to form, there is a fluid filled space. This space is called antrum. It is in the secondary follicle. And this secondary follicle is converted into mature or graafian follicle. And graafian follicle is only one. And then it is surrounding the secondary oocyte, which again arrested at meiosis 2, stage 2, which is metaphase. And then the remaining granulosa or follicular cell are converted into a yellowish mass which is called corpus luteum. It will produce the progesterone, and now the ovum surrounded by some follicular cells, it is taken up by the fallopian. Ovum is Now this ovum is which was taken up by fallopian tube. Now this is fallopian tube. At the time of ovulation, the ovum with the cumulus oophorus cell which are surrounding the zona pellucida, these cells rearrange themselves and they look like crowns. So these cells are called corona radiata. These cells are called corona radiata cells. Now their genetic makeup is 23 haploid number of chromosome and the amount of DNA is 2N. So if the sperm will not come, they cell wait in the fallopian tube for 24 to 48 hours and then they will undergo necrosis and apoptosis and die. Now this is Scandri. Now the ovum with the Scandri oocyte. Now the Scandri ovum with corona radiata wait for the sperm. Now if the sperm come and touch the membrane of Scandri ovum, this Scandri ovum. Now the Scandri ovum will reactivate it and it rapidly completes its second meiotic division. It means that now it will form the first polar body is divide into further two polar bodies and the secondary ova it will convert it into one with more cytoplasm into definite ovum and other polar body. So overall three polar body with definite ova are formed. So at the time of fertilization, what events will occur? First of all, first meiotic division is complete. Another polar body is formed, definite ovum. So the product of fertilization which is formed is zygote.